This video goes with section 21 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek Unintensive course and covers the imperfect indicative active of thematic verbs that end in omega. You can refer to Hansen and Quinn on this subject on pages 46 and 47 or in the appendix on page 652. The imperfect indicative active is past time and continuous or repeated aspect, and to form it we need something new, the past indicative augment. Greek uses it any time a verb is in past time, so that's the imperfect, the aorist, and the pluperfect. It's only for indicative forms, so anything in those tenses that's not indicative, not for questions or statements of fact, doesn't get or loses the augment. And it's an augment, an add-on at the beginning of the verb. It's an epsilon added at the beginning. We talk about it as the augment, or sometimes as the PIA. So let's get back to the imperfect indicative active. It's past time and indicative, so we need the PIA, the past indicative augment, plus the stem from the first principal part, plus the endings of the imperfect. So let's start with Luo's first principal part, and get the stem by taking off the omega. And we add the augment. Now, we need the endings in a chart to put them in, singular and plural, first, second, and third person. Here are the endings of the imperfect singular. On, s, e, which can also have a new movable. And here are the endings of the plural. Amen, ete, on. Notice that the third person plural and the first person singular have the same ending, so you'll need to use context to decide how to translate. Also, notice that the first person plural and the second person plural are exactly the same endings that you already know from the present indicative active, so the difference will be the augment. Also familiar is the sigma at the end of the second person singular. Accent on most Greek verbs and is recessive, and that's the case here. The default translation for the imperfect indicative active is she was verbing for past time and continuous aspect. She used to verb or she kept verbing could also be good choices depending on the context. So let's put this together. Augment plus principal part 1 plus the endings and recessive accent. We need a chart to put them in. You start with the augment. Add principal part 1. And so here we have the persons and numbers filled in with the augment plus the stem from the first principal part of Luo. And now we need the endings. So let's add them in. On, s, a, or n, amen, ete, on. Now we need recessive accent. So, if you look at the last syllable, to follow the rules for recessive accent, you have to look and see if they're long or short, and that tells you how far back the acute can recede on the verb. So let's look at eluon, the first person singular. It has a short last syllable, so we count 1, 2, 3, and add the acute on the third to last. Second person singular, s is short, so we go 1, 2, 3, and add the acute. Third person singular, e is short, 1, 2, 3, and there's our acute on the third to last. In the plural, the epsilon in men is short, so we go 1, 2, 3, and add the acute. Second person plural, short, 1, 2, 3, add the acute on the third to last. And finally, third person plural, short, 2, 3, and add the acute. That's the whole conjugation of the imperfect indicative active of luo. Eluon, I was freeing. Elues, you were freeing. Elue, or eluen, she was freeing, or he was freeing, or it was freeing. Eluomen, we were freeing. Eluete, y'all were freeing. And eluon, they were freeing. Let's try it with another verb. Here's paideuo in all its six principal parts. We go to the first principal part, start with the augment, add our stem, add the ending, and the recessive accent. So we get epaideuon, I was educating. Epaideuos, you were educating. Augment, stem, ending, epaideuē, she was educating. Or epaideuēn, he was educating, it was educating, or still, she was educating. Epaideuōmen, we were educating. Augment, stem, ending, accent, epaideuēte, y'all were educating. And finally, epaideuon, they were educating. Notice that because every ending is short in the last syllable, not only does the augment help us see that we're looking at the imperfect and the slightly different endings, but the placement of the accent helps us understand that we are in a different tense from the present indicative active. And there you have imperfect indicative active. You should be ready for drills, classwork, and translations.